Hi dear students, I am Srinivasan from Sri Sai Sadbhavana School. Now we are already completed the two lessons. We are moving to third lesson, Fertile Plains of Northern India. When you come to the first lesson, in the first lesson they have given the physical features. The physical features, page number 3, the Greater Himalayas, the Fertile Plains of India, the Great Indian Desert, the Coastal Plains of Thailand, the Southern Plateau. That means the physical features. How many physical features has there in India? 5 physical features. India has divided into 5 physical features. In that, the first one is the Great Himalayas. The Great Himalayas we have learnt in the second lesson. The third lesson is the Fertile Plains of North India. What we are now learning. That means now the continuation is about the physical features. One lesson about the one physical feature. Now we will study about the fertile plains of northern India. What first we will learn, what is the meaning of the plain? They have given here, I will read. Plains are flat, vast, low-lying areas where the soil is very fertile because of the river flowing through them. Early human settlements started in the plains adjacent to the river. The river deposit alluvial soil which is fine, soft and rich in minerals. Being fertile, this soil is suitable for agriculture. Hence, agriculture become the main occupation of the people. The Gangetic Plain in the northern part of India is one of India's most fertile regions. It is also known as the food bowl of India. This part has a huge deposit of alluvial soil and is the most populous region in our country. What is the meaning of plain? Plain is the flat. That means that looks like a flat area and vast. So much of land, not in a just acres or kilometers like that, so much of acres land, low-lying areas, that means not in the height, they are the low-lying areas where soil is very fertile. Soil is very, very fertile because of the river flowing through them. So many rivers are flowing in the plain. For example, River Ganga, River Brahmaputra, all these things. Where they origin in the Himalayan mountains. They origin in the Himalayan mountains. After that, they move to the southwards of the Himalayan mountain. That is the northern part of the India. So therefore we call them as fertile plains of northern India. Plains are the areas where we are getting the flat surface land, fertile land besides the river. Besides the river, or the rivers are flowing in that land, they are called as plain. Early human settlement started in the plains adjacent to the rivers. That means if the rivers are flowing like this, this side and this side, these are called the plains. Because here we are getting the more water by these rivers for the agriculture purpose. Here the population is also more because we are getting the water easily. So everywhere agriculture land, everywhere we are doing the agriculture. Early human settlements, that means before the man originates, when the evolution of the man starts, they live near the rivers. Why? Because they want water throughout the year. By this river they get the water throughout the year. For that reason only they stay near the river banks. Banks means this area. If this is the river, this is called as the bank. River banks. These areas are called as river banks. For this reason only, the early human settlement started in the plains adjacent to the rivers, because at that time there is no borewell, there is no any dams or anything. Just they depend on the river water for their basic needs, for drinking, for everything, for bathing, okay, to grow the crops, to feed the animals, everything. They need this river water only. For that reason only, they will get easily the water. They settle near the rivers. The rivers deposit alluvial soil which is fine, often rich in minerals. While moving, in the second chapter you have learned, the Ganga and Brahmaputra, they bring the fertile soil, that is called as alluvial soil. What we call it as? Alluvial soil, which is fine, very smooth, soft and rich in minerals. That is very very important. All the minerals are present which are helpful to grow the crops very well. To grow the crops very well. Being fertile, this soil is suitable for agriculture purpose. So here the soil is very very fertile, so it is very good for growing the plants, sorry, for the agriculture purpose. Hence, agriculture becomes the main occupation of the people. Here, what is the main occupation? Agriculture is the main occupation of the people. The Gangetic Plain in the northern part of India is one of India's most fertile regions. In our India, the Gangetic region, that means where the river Ganga flows in our India, that region is called as the Gangetic region or Gangetic Plain. We call it as the Gangetic Plain. It is the very fertile land. Very fertile land or fertile region. It is also known as food bowl of India. It is also known as the food bowl of India because so much of food crops are grown there. This part has a huge deposit of alluvial soil and is the most populous region in our country. This part has a huge deposit of alluvial soil. As I already explained, that the rivers bring the alluvial soil. So in this region, population is more. Population is more, most populous region. Populous means population is more. What is the meaning of population? The people, the number of people living in this area is more. Next come to location, where these northern plains are located. The northern plain lies to the south of the Great Himalayas. It is bounded by the desert, Thar Desert in the west, Purvanchal ranges in the east and Southern Plateau in the south. The plain stretches from Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. This is about 2400 kilometers long. How much kilometers long? 2400 kilometers long. Here they are given in the figure. Just to look at the textbook. In the green they have marked. In the green color they have marked. Okay. Once again I will explain. The northern plain lies to the south of the greater Himalayas. That means below the greater Himalayas, these northern plains locate. It is bounded by the, that means the boundary of this Thar Desert in the west. In the west, this is the west. This is the Thar Desert. Okay. Purvanchal ranges in the east and the Southern Plateau in the south. This is the Southern Plateau. Below this Gujarat, everything becomes the, sorry, Madhya Pradesh. So this becomes the Southern Plateau. In this, in between, this northern plain lies. The plain stretches from Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. From Punjab to Assam, it stretches, it is about 2400 kilometers. 2400 kilometers long. This length is 2400 kilometers long. Okay, they are given the northern plain. Come to physical features. Physical features. I will read. The northern plain is formed by the deposition of soil brought by the perennial rivers, the Satluj, the Ganga, the Brahmaputra and their tributaries. These rivers originate from the Himalayan ranges and gush down the mountains with great speed, breaking down the rocks into pieces and carrying them along. When they reach the plains at the foot of the Himalayas, their speed of flow is reduced and they deposit alluvial soil there. Rivers flow through the plains as channels. The riverbed and the plains on its side together form the river basin. Here they have given the physical features. The northern plain is formed by the deposition of soil brought by the perennial rivers. Perennial rivers means the rivers which are flowing throughout the year. Throughout the year they are flowing. In our area, the rivers. In the summer season, they won't flow because there is no source. But in the summer, they have the much source by the Himalayan mountains. The ice in the Himalaya melts due to the sun heat, and it flows in the form of water. And it flows in the form of water in these rivers. The names of the rivers are the Satluj, the Ganga, and the Brahmaputra, and their tributaries. What is the meaning of tributaries? The small rivers which are joining to the main rivers are called as tributaries. These rivers originate from the Himalayan ranges. Originate means start or take birth in the Himalayan ranges and gush down the mountains. Gush down means flow or move towards the mountains with great speed. With great speed, breaking down the rocks into pieces. The rocks which are present in the mountains, they are rubbed with this water and it becomes into small, small pieces. That pieces become once again the soil. That is the alluvial soil. And carrying them along, not only making into small pieces, carrying them along. When they reach the plains at the foot of the Himalayas, when they are moving from the Himalayan mountain, when they reach the foot of the hill, that is the foot of the Himalayan mountain, their speed becomes slow. Their speed is reduced. That means their speed becomes slow and they deposit alluvial soil there. When they are moving fast, they are taking it. When they are very slow, they are depositing there only. Rivers flow through the plains as channels. Here they will flow in the form of channels. This is called as a channel. That means in a way. In a way, we call this as the channel. That means in the borders, it will move. There is a boundary. In that boundary only, it will flow. They are called as the channels. The riverbed and the plains on its sides together form the river basin. That means on both the sides, we call it as riverbank or river basin. Okay. They have given a basin. I will read. A basin is a low-lying area drained by rivers and their tributaries. The sediment that these rivers hold become very dense. So these rivers break into many small rivers called tributaries, forming a triangular piece of land before joining the sea. This piece of land is known as a delta. The Sundarban Delta, the largest delta in the world, lies at the mouth of the Ganga and the Brahmaputra rivers. It occupies about 4,000 square kilometers of area. Here they have given about the basin, tributaries and the delta. What is a basin? I have explained. A basin is a low-lying area drained by rivers and their tributaries. That means the tributaries will join, the rivers, the main rivers are flowing. So that area where they are flowing besides sides of the river is called as a basin, or the way where it is flowing full from the starting to the end, that full area is called as basin. The sediments that these rivers hold become very dense. That means when they others are joining, they become very dense. Dense means very fast, or the quantity of water becomes more. The quantity of water becomes more. So these rivers break into small rivers called tributaries. When the water becomes more, it will divide into two. It will divide into two because there is no space to move in a single way. Then what it will do? It will divide into the next way. That means it will divide, okay, forming a triangular piece of land before joining the sea. That means while moving, the water is more. If some land is there, it will turn. It will break into two pieces. It will break into two pieces and making this piece as a triangle shape. This land is called as delta. This land is called as delta. That means while moving, if the force of water is there, or quantity of water becomes more by the distributaries, sorry, by their tributaries, okay, then they divide into two parts, making the land in the center. So that land area is called as delta. That land area is called as delta. One name of the one delta which is formed by the Ganga River is the Sundarban Delta. Sundarban Delta, the largest delta in the world, lies at the mouth of the Ganga and the Brahmaputra River. Here what happens? The Ganga and Brahmaputra, both rivers are meeting. Okay. In that Sundarban Delta, so here it will form a triangular-like structure, triangular-like a island. It occupies about 4000 square kilometers in area. How many kilometers? 4000 kilometers. What is this square kilometers? 4000 square kilometers. What is the meaning of square kilometer? 1 kilometer length, 1 kilometer width. 1 kilometer length, 1 kilometer width. This area is called as 1 square kilometer. Just imagine 1 kilometer, 1 kilometer, 1 kilometer, 1 kilometer. This much area, this area is called as 1 square kilometer. Just imagine 1 kilometer in the road. 1 kilometer like this in the road. Why 1 kilometer? And 1 kilometer. How much land area is covered? That is called as 1 square kilometer. Okay. That types for 4000. 4000 kilometer like this. Okay. 4000 kilometer. 4000 kilometer. And 4000 kilometer. If you imagine this area, that much area. But there, it is not in a perfect square. It is in the form of a triangular shape. It is in the shape of triangle. But the area is covered is called as is 4000 square kilometers. 4000 square kilometers. Next, division of the northern plain. The northern plain is broadly divided into three parts. The Satluj, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra basin. This northern plain divides into three basins or three parts. That is the Satluj, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. Because these are the three main rivers. These are the three big rivers which are flowing from the Himalayas. So they have divided into the Satluj, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra basin. First one, the Satluj basin. The western part of the northern fertile plain is the Satluj basin. River Satluj along with its tributary Bees drains the lowland of Punjab and Haryana forming the Satluj basin. Then it enters into Pakistan to join River Indus. The region gets very fertile, very little rainfall. The climate is hot in summer and very cold in winter. That means basin. Wherever the river is flowing, that area is called as basin. I have already explained. So wherever this Satluj river flows, that is called as the Satluj basin. The western part of the northern fertile plain, western part, is called as the Satluj basin. River Satluj along with its tributary Bees, B-E-A-S, the name of the river, small river, drains the lowland of Punjab, Haryana, forming the Satluj basin. That means in the states of Punjab and Haryana, this Satluj basin is present. Then it enters into Pakistan to join River Indus. After flowing in our India, it moves towards the Pakistan. It moves into the Pakistan. It joins the River Indus. It joins the River Indus. The region gets very little rainfall. In this region, it gets very, very little rainfall. Due to this Satluj River only, they are making the agriculture. They are doing the agriculture. The climate is hot in summer and very cold in winter. Whatever the climate, it is very hot in the summer and very, very cold in the winter. Here they have given the Bakra Dam. See, this is the Bakra Dam. You know the dam? Yes. Where we are storing the water in so much of quantity, in a huge quantity or large quantity, that is called as the dam. It is constructed between the two mountains. It is constructed between the two mountains where the river is flowing. The main source is the river. Okay. The river is flowing. We are making a stop for it to store the water. Next come to Ganga Basin. River Ganga originates in the Himalayas at Gomukh. Gangotri, an icy glacier, is the source of River Ganga. Yamunotri glacier is the source of River Yamuna. As the glaciers melt during summer, they form perennial rivers. River Ganga enters the plain at Haridwar. Gomati, Ghagra, Gandak and Kosi are the other tributaries of River Ganga. They also have their origin in the Himalayas and drain the lowland called the Ganga Basin. The Plateau River, Chambal and Betwa are the tributaries of River Yamuna in the north. River Sun is the tributary of River Ganga in the south. Here they are given about the Ganga Basin, wherever the Ganga and Brahmaputra River, sorry, Ganga and Yamuna rivers are flowing. River Ganga originates in the Himalayas at Gomukh. That place is called as Gangotri. In the last lesson, it's we have studied an icy glacier. It starts from the icy glacier, that is the Gangotri. It is the main source of the river Ganga. Yamunotri glacier is the source of river Yamuna. Yamunotri is the river source of Yamuna. As the glaciers melt during summer, they form perennial rivers. That means they are flowing throughout the year. River Ganga enters the plain at Haridwar, where it enters the plain. After the Himalayas, it enters the Indian northern plain in the Haridwar. Gomati, Ghagra, Gandak and Kosi are the other tributaries of River Ganga. These are the small rivers which joins the River Ganga. Which are they? Gomati, Ghagra, Gandak and Kosi. These are the small rivers. We are not saying about small. They are also very big rivers. They will join the main river. They are joined the main river Ganga. They also have their origin in the Himalayas. These also origin in the Himalayas. That means they also start in the Himalayas and drain the lowland called the Ganga Basin. The plateau rivers Chambal and Betwa are the tributaries of River Yamuna in the north. River Sun is the tributary of River Ganga in the south. That means the plateau rivers Chambal and Betwa are tributaries of River Yamuna. Which are the other joining rivers of Yamuna are Chambal, Betwa. These are the names of the rivers. River Sun is the tributary of River Ganga in the south. In the southern area, another one river is joining the Ganga, that is River Sun. S-O-N. Next, the Triveni Sangam. The Triveni Sangam, also known as Prayag, is the site of confluence of the rivers Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati at Prayagraj. Earlier known as Allahabad, River Saraswati is invisible and is believed to be flowing under the earth. It meets the other two rivers from underneath. So here we call this as Triveni Sangama. Triveni Sangama. In our Karnataka, we have one Sangama near Srirangapatna. There three rivers are meeting. Same way, here Triveni Sangama, that means three rivers, which are the rivers Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati are meeting at one place. Our Indians believe that meeting place is a holy place because we are getting the three rivers at one place. If you take birth, it is good for all the pujas and everything. Okay. So for that reason, every year, so many visitors are visiting here. First, we will discuss about what is the Triveni Sangam. The Triveni Sangam, also known as Prayag, it is also called by another name Prayag, is the site of confluence of the rivers. Confluence means meeting place. Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati at Prayagraj. Earlier it is called as the Allahabad. Now it is named by Prayagraj. The name is one they have renamed. It has the Prayagraj. Which are the rivers? Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati. These are three are meeting at a point. But visible are only two, the Ganga and Yamuna. The Saraswati is flowing in under the earth. Under that means they are joining inside. Okay. River Saraswati is invisible and is believed to be flowing under the earth. It meets the other two rivers from underneath. From the below the earth, it joins these two rivers. They believe that the Saraswati river also joins with these two rivers, that is Ganga and Yamuna. The Triveni Sangam is a sacred place for the Hindus and is of religious importance. The Ganga takes a sharp turn here and it divides into two distributaries. Here in the Triveni Sangam, the Ganga takes into a sharp turn. That means like a sharp turn like this. Okay. Here the Triveni Sangam is a sacred place for that religious people. That means Indian people or Hindu people or all the Indians are wish to visit one time in their lifetime. The Ganga takes a sharp turn here and it divides into two tributaries or distributaries. That means it divides into two parts. River Hooghly, one of its distributaries, flows through West Bengal. And here it divides into two. One is called as the River Hooghly. river Hooghly, and it moves through, it flows through the West Bengal. The other distributary flows into Bangladesh and joins river Brahmaputra, and another one moves to the Bangladesh and joins with the river Brahmaputra. The river formed by their confluences is known as Padma. The confluence means by this joining we call it as the river Padma. The Ganga basin receives more rainfall than the Satluj basin. That means in the Ganga basin, now we are watching in the TVs in the northern India, so much of rainfall, the rivers are flowing with so much of water. Here in the Ganga basin there is a heavy rainfall. Summers are very hot and winters are very cold. The summers are very hot and the winters are cold. Next it is the Brahmaputra basin. We will continue in the next class. Okay, I hope you understand up to here about the location of the northern water plains of northern India, how they have formed, what how it is become the food bowl of India, and physical features, divisions of the northern plains, that is Satluj basin, Ganga basin and the Brahmaputra basin, about the Tribeni Sangam, everything we have learned. This Tribeni Sangam, see here how many people are gathered here. In some special days, lakhs together people are gathered here to make bath, to take bath, because their belief. This is about the Tribeni Sangam. I hope you understand very well. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Please like and subscribe our channel.